Hello everyone! The popularity of the Blender program is growing more and more every day. This is due to its versatility and ease of use. In today's video, I'll tell and show you the basics of working in Blender for beginners. Have a comfortable seat, make some tea, and here we go! Now I'll quickly tell you how to move around in Blender. You can use the mouse wheel to move closer or further away from an object. To rotate around an object, all you have to do is hold down the mouse wheel. But to move, you have to hold down Shift and the wheel on the mouse. You can also move with these tools in the corner. In the opposite corner, we have a tapped panel. This shows you what mode we are in at the moment. Right now it's object mode. Of these four tabs, the most important one is Add. We will use it to add all objects to our scene. You can also open this panel with the Shift plus AK combination. I add a cube to the scene. Suppose I want to change the cube. You can do it in this window. But the easiest way to do it is to use hotkeys. For example, the J key changes the position of the object. The R key rotates the object. And the S key increases or decreases an object. You can also edit objects along a certain axis. To do this, press the appropriate key and select the axis X, Y or Z. For example, we press J and Y. As we see, our object moves only on this axis. You can do the same with rotation and resizing of the object. With the numbers 1, 3, 7, 9 on the numpad, you can look at the object from different perspectives. And so, using scale, I will change the shape for our future object. Go into this section here. Here you can add different modifiers that will modify our object. Each modifier is needed for some specific task. Personally, I need to add a chamfer to the object, so I choose the bevel modifier. This is the box where you can adjust it. I specify 70 segments. As a result, we have such a rectangle. Now we need to extrude the area for the future screen. To do this here in this window, choose Edit Mode. You can also do this with the Tab key. As we see, our rectangle consists of four corners, each of which can be changed, thus deforming the figure. You can do the same with the faces and sides by selecting the desired option here, or by pressing 1, 2 or 3 on the keyboard. Now we need to add cuts. To do this, I press Ctrl plus R and put the cursor in the middle of the object. Roll the mouse wheel and press the left mouse button. We press S and X to move the cuts. Do the same in the horizontal direction. Make one more cut to make a rectangle in the middle. Select the plane. Press E and Y, extrude it in. Should get something like this. After that, with Ctrl plus R, I make cuts on the side of the future console. And I change their position and size. Now I select these planes. Press I to extrude the faces. And press the plane on the x-axis with extrude. Thus we have the ventilation holes. Now let's create buttons for the console. I will add a cube. Press slash to switch to object isolation mode. Now you can work separately with a specific object. I will reduce the cube. Flatten it. I cut it horizontally and vertically in editing mode. Turn on transparency mode with Alt plus Z. Delete angular planes, X faces. Select this edge. I press F to close the void. Also close the rest. Exit isolation mode. Let's put the button under the console. Next, I will add a cylinder. Let's rotate it 90 degrees on the X axis. Reduce. I'll put it under the console. To copy the object, we press Shift plus D and move it. Smooth the round buttons with Shape Smooth and Auto Smooth. Add a cone, a cylinder and a sphere to make an antenna. Let's change their size and attach them to the console. To see the materials of the object, we press Z and select Render. Click on the tab Render Settings. Select the render type, Cycles. And I will select GPU Compute to render on the video card. Max samples, I will specify 512. In the Work tab, in Color, I will select Environment Texture. I will choose my favorite background. In the Render Settings, I will turn on transparency of the background. Next, we add a plane. Press S and 100, thereby increase the plane 100 times. In this step, we will add a material. Click the plus sign and new. In base color, I will choose the color you like. Then on the same principle, we add material and specify the color for the remaining objects. For ventilation, the principle is slightly different. Let's add a material. Press Tab. Select the faces you want with Shift hold down. Select the new material. Press Assign to assign the material to the selected area. And choose a dark color. In the same way, we create material for the screen and assign it. To add a creeper to the screen, we click on the point near gray color. Select image texture. Press open and select the image. Press tab. UV. Project from view bounds to make the image fit the screen. Add lighting. Light. Sun. In the item settings, in transformation for rotation, I will specify 10 degrees on the X axis. Add camera. Select the perspective in viewport. Press Ctrl plus Alt and numpad 0 for the camera to apply the perspective. Now we change the angle of the camera so that we like it. The last thing we need to do is render and save the image. Press Render, Render Image or F12. Once the render is complete, we press Image and choose Save to save the image. Friends, if this video was really useful to you, don't forget to like it and subscribe to my channel. That way I will know that you are interested in the Blender videos and I will try to release them more often. All useful links are in the description. See you very soon. Don't miss me. Bye everyone.